I've been looking at some images of interesting architecture, and this one popped out. I really liked these sloped balconies, and I thought, why not do that in Revit? So today we're going to have another Balkan Architect Revit gameplay tutorial where I find interesting architecture and recreate it in Revit. Let's go! Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. There you can find all of my Revit courses. I've got over 140 hours of content, and I'm adding more each month. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we have this building which we prepared as kind of our first starting point. You can see we already have the balconies here. Now these balconies are essentially really simple. So if I go here into edit boundary, you can see it's simply a floor which was extended a little bit in order to create this balcony floor. Now let's add the railing. So all of this sloped railing or sloped balconies, this will be done with walls just because they're a little bit easier to manipulate than regular railing in Revit. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to go here to the wall tool, and then if I go up, you can see we have this balcony wall which I've prepared. And here if we go into edit type, it's actually just a simple thin wall, less than 6 centimeters in thickness. So I'm just going to click OK. And now to place it, I'm just going to change the location line to finish face exterior. And then in the draw tools, you want to pick lines. And now let's zoom in here to this, which is on level one, so the first balcony. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to change the base constraint to level one, and then the top constraint to unconnected 100 centimeters, hit apply. And then when we come close to the edge here, make sure to come from the outside, and then you click, you do the same thing here. Here as well. So you basically have that wall forming on the inside. See how that dashed line appears on the inside? That's what you want to see here as well. And then finally here. And I'm just going to repeat that same process here. But for that, let's change the level to level two. And then we can just do the same thing. And finally, one more here. Okay, perfect. So once we have placed these walls, let's hit the escape key a couple of times, and then we just want to adjust them here so they don't go through the curtain wall, which you don't definitely don't want. So for that, we can go here to modify and then pick the align tool. AL is the shortcut. Find the bottom mullion here and just attach this wall to that, and then repeat the same thing here, and repeat the same thing for the balcony below that. So I'm just going to show you on these two examples, and then it's basically the same process for the two up here. Okay, so once we have the balconies in place, now it's actually time to create that slope, so the fun part. So to create that slope, what you want to do is you want to create a void which is going to be cutting through this balcony. So to create that void, what I'm going to do is go here to Architecture and then go to Component and click on Model in Place. For the category, you want to pick out something like Generic Component or Generic Models and then click OK. We can leave it at generic models one, that's perfectly fine. And now let's create that void. So the first step is going to be to set our work plane. So we can go here to pick a plane, and then I'm just going to pick this plane here. Now, if you're working in older versions of Revit, you would go here to set work plane and then choose pick a plane and then just repeat the same process. This is only, I think, in Revit 2024 and maybe 2023. I'm not really sure. So anyways, now let's go to one of the elevations. So I think south elevation should be the one. Yeah, definitely, that's the one. Now we go here to void extrusion, and then, okay, so it's the same plane here. And then let's go to pick lines, or actually let's just go with lines and start with here from here and then go up. It doesn't really matter how far up you go. Usually you just don't want to go too far up just because we don't really need that. So anyways, let's click here now a little bit here in the middle, hit the escape key a few times, select this, and then this year I want to be 55. So this side of the void will start from 55, and then I'm just going to create a small line segment here. So just a few centimeters, so something like, yeah, this. So basically covering that edge of that wall. Okay, so once we have this, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to approximately here and then connect it with this side. Now, the reason why I did this is so now I can switch to fillet arc, and then I can just fillet this arc a little bit like that. And now we have a smoother line here. Now, of course, you can change this angle if you want, or you can just try again. If you're not happy with that angle, you can go again to fillet arc and then see what works. Okay, I think this works even better. So let's just leave it at this. And there we go. So now I'm just going to hit finish. That's going to create an extrusion. Then we can navigate to level 2. I think this is on level 2. Yeah. And then extend it all the way in like this. Go to the 3D view, see what we have. There we go. Perfect. And now we can just go here to cut geometry, select multiple cut, select this, and then just start cutting these elements here. And I think the last one we don't even have to cut because we have a straight line there. And we just hit finish. Yeah, see, because I've clicked on it, it's telling me that it's just not cutting through that. That's okay. And this is what we have. So we have that nice sloped balcony, and we have a nice organic line going down. Now, to repeat this down here, just to make it a bit easier for us, I'm just going to click here on the edge. See how when we have this void, when I hover over this edge, just the edge highlights. And if I select that and go to edit in place, I can select that void. So you want to do this just because you can then go to edit extrusion. You can select that profile for our void, go to Control C to copy, or just go here to copy the clipboard, and then hit finish. And finish just to exit out of that model. And now what we can do is we can go here to architecture, go to component, model in place, start a new generic model family. Let's go to the south elevation as well. Go here to set work plane, pick a plane, pick this one here, and then go again to void extrusion. And now I can just go here to paste from clipboard, and I can just paste this here. See? So now what I'll do is I'm just going to select this, go to move, and then let's just move it down to this edge here. And then let's see what this looks like. Yeah, so it might make perhaps more sense to move it to this side like that, and then just extend it here. There we go. So we don't have to remodel this again or draw this again. It's already done, so I can hit finish. Go back to level 1. Yeah, this is on level 1, and then just extend it to go past that balcony here. I just stopped here at the edge. Go back to the 3D view, and now again we want to cut this, so you go to cut, select multiple cut, and then select the void and just start cutting through the walls like this. And then this one we don't even have to cut, and just hit finish model, and there we go. Now in that image, if you remember, it looks like we have some horizontal planks or something like that on this balcony, so let's try to mimic that as well. For that, what you'll do is go here to architecture and then go to wall, and let's go to wall reveal, and I'm just going to place this small reveal which I've created, and then let's select the reveal itself, set the offset from level to 10 centimeters or something like that. There we go. Then we want to add remove walls, so like that, and then you just click on all of the walls where you want that reveal to appear. So just like this, perfect. And then we can select that reveal again. Let's see. Okay, looks good. Oh, here. Nope. It's good. Yeah, it just looked a little bit weird at one place. So anyways, now once we have this reveal created, let's go back to south elevation, and then we can just array it. So here I can go to, I don't know, something like 7, and then let's go to last, go from here, go up, and just let's see what that looks like. Yeah, perfect. So we have now created that balcony, and now you would just repeat the same thing on this one here. And now with a little bit of extra work, we can get to something that looks like this. So as you can see, the balconies are completed, the sloped balconies are completed, and also I've added these plants. So if you're interested in these plant families, those are available on my website. So you can find numerous highly realistic families on my website. So I'm just going to link that up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. And if you would like to explore my Revit project files from this tutorial, so this building that we have here, or any of my other Revit project files from the tutorials in the past, you can find all of that on my Patreon page, which I'm also going to link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.